we decided to come to local high schools to give both the students in the public schools as well as the Wake Forest students an opportunity to learn things about genetics and genetically modified organisms. We know that schools cover genetics already, but we decided that it would be a memorable experience to bring purple tomatoes to the school so that they could see an example of genetic inheritance. The students in the schools, also we want them to understand what genetically modified organisms, or GMOs, are. We hear a lot about that in the news and in the grocery store, and we all have to make a decision whether we want to buy these or not. And so we wanted to bring the science behind how they're made to the schools.
We start by talking about drought, which is affecting one of our major states, California, where a lot of our crop production comes from. And then we move into a scenario where we have these purple mutant tomatoes and these red tomatoes that are our normal tomatoes. The purple ones have been shown to be slightly drought resistant. We look at their root systems and see that they have more roots. From this scenario, we teach them about the genetics, Punnett squares, we go over dihybrid crosses, and we end by telling them about genetically modified organisms and exactly how we genetically modify these organisms. This is material that they're also learning about in their Bio 101 class. So by teaching it, we're hoping that it'll give them a better understanding. But it also allows us to interact with the community around Wake Forest and to be more involved in the community, and gives them a chance to volunteer at local high schools.
This is also good for the Wake Forest students because they've learned these things in their class, and now they're having a chance to learn even better through teaching other students. And so explaining basic genetic inheritance and GMOs and really putting this all together is a great experience for them.